हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। लेट्स स्टडी विथ योर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज टीचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू पोएम। द नेम ऑफ द पोएम इज द लेबरनम टॉप एंड इट्स पोएट इज टेड हुक्स। इन द लेबरनम टॉप, टेड हुक्स डिस्क्राइब्स हाउ द लेबरनम ट्रीज टॉप इज साइलेंट, लाइफलेस in the absence of the goldfinch. The coming of the sweet singing yellow bird makes all the difference. The tree comes to life with chirrupings, chitterings and trillings, but the same laburnum tree becomes empty and silent again the moment the bird flies away. So before starting the poem, I would like to request you to lend me your ears, eyes, as well as minds also. Let's start the poem. First stanza. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. In the afternoon yellow September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. So let's first explain those lines side by side, word meaning also. The laburnum top is silent. How is the laburnum tree? Okay, before that I would like to tell you what is laburnum tree. A short tree with hanging branches, yellow flowers. The laburnum top is silent and empty. The top of the laburnum tree is silent. There is no activity. It is still and silent in the yellow sunlight of the September afternoon. A few of its leaves are turning yellow. All its seeds have fallen. So the meaning of silent is quiet, quiet, and silent is adjective. What part of speech is silent? Adjective. And next word is after silent, that is quiete. My dear students, quiet is adjective and quiet is adverb. So quite still, that means completely still, completely motionless. In the afternoon yellow September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, yellowing, that means turning yellow. All its seeds have fallen. Let's proceed to the next stanza. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end, then sleek as lizard, an alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Of chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings, the whole tree trembles and thrills. It is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, then flats out branch end, showing her bird face identity mask. Let's infer word meaning side by side, its explanation also. The top of laburnum tree remains silent till goldfinch comes. So what is goldfinch? Goldfinch is a small singing bird with yellow feathers. Goldfinch is a small singing bird with yellow feathers. The top of the laburnum tree remains silent till goldfinch comes. The bird makes sharp, sudden and surprising chirrups. The goldfinch is glossy and smooth like a lizard. She is watchful and abrupt. She enters the thickness of leaves and branches, among the leaves of machine. Amongst the leaves, a machine of sharp chittering starts. She flutters her wings and sings in short but loud notes. Let's infer the meaning of some new words. Twitching. Twitching means pulling or contracting with a jerk. Pulling or contracting with a jerk. Next word, chirrup. An onomatopoeic word capturing the sound made by the goldfinch. We got the word in the very first lesson, the portrait of a lady, Khushbant Singh. A suddenness. Suddenness means abrupt. Startlement. Startlement means amazement. AMAZDMENT. Slick. SLEEK. Slick. Slick means smooth. SMOOTH. Then sleek as a lizard. My dear students, here a comparison is drawn in between the goldfinch and the lizard. Sleek as lizard and alerts and abrupt, she enters. Here she refers to the goldfinch. So sleek as lizard. This is simile, figure of speech. In a simile, you know, an explicit comparison is drawn in between two dissimilar or unallied. Dissimilar means unallied, UNALLIED, dissimilar or unallied things or ideas. So here a comparison is drawn in between lizard smoothness and as sleek as lizard and the slickness of smoothness of the bird goldfinch. And abrupt. What is the meaning of abrupt? Sudden or unexpected. That is abrupt. Achanak. She enters. She, already we have said, this pronoun stands for the goldfinch bird. She enters. The thickness. What is thickness? Among the leaves and branches. That is thickness. And a machine starts up. My dear students, before the very coming of the goldfinch bird, in the laburnum top, what was reigning? Complete silence. And that silence stands for just a lifelessness. Understood? But with the very coming of the goldfinch, the same laburnum top, it's got completely changed. That's why what is used here, and a machine starts up. So mechanism, understood? There was stillness, but now there is life also. She enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Of chitterings. Chitterings means chirrupings. And tremor. Tremor means shiver or jerky movements. MOVEMENTS, movements of wings. And trillings. Trillings means singing repeatedly. This word is also onomatopoeic word. Understood? And this short high pitched sound of the goldfinch. So we know that what is onomatopoeia. The sound of a word gives its sense and figures based on sound. There is no need to give the meaning. The very sound gives the meaning. The whole tree trembles, shakes, SHAKES, and thrills and gets excited with the very coming of the goldfinch. The whole tree Now activity started. Sex, thrills, gets excited. It is the engine of our family. It is the engine of our family. Her family refers to the family of goldfinch. She stokes. Stokes means adds fuel. The bird feeds its family, providing the fuel, that is nutrition. Understood? Adds fuel. The bird feeds its family, providing the fuel, that is nutrition, that the machine, here machine, the bird's family, refers to the bird's family, needs to be energetic. So before the very coming of the goldfinch, its family, that machine, there was no life. But with the very coming of the goldfinch, it is enlivened. There is full of activity. There is full of life, energetic energy is there. Understood? Restores its life. Before, in the first stanza, lifeless, but in the second stanza, we find the tree. Understood? What returns? Life. Vivacity is there. V-I-V-A-C-I-T-Y. And its even family members, the bird goldfinch is feeding its young ones who are expectantly waiting for the food. Without that, there was no life. Lifeless, they were just leading an inactive life. But with the very coming of the goldfinch, the goldfinch has enlivened. That means added life, or everything, and even the tree also, there is excitement. Understood? It is the engine of our family. She stokes. She adds fuel. The bird feeds its family, providing the fuel, nutrition, that the machine here is the bird's family, needs to be energetic. Energetic hone ke liye, aapko, what is needed? Machine mein petrol, diesel, but here food is required. So stokes we have discussed. Next. Then, so this is the last stanza. Let's proceed to the last stanza. Then, with eerie, delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite, and the laburnum subsides to empty. Subsides. S-U-B-S-I-D-A. Subsides to empty. Then with eerie means strange, delicate means very soft, whistle chirrup, whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite, and the laburnum subsides to empty. So this stanza requires proper explanation. Then the goldfinch, with her strange, delicate whistlings, chirrupings, and whisperings, flies away towards the finite, towards the infinite sky. After her departure, the laburnum tree becomes empty and silent again. Complete stillness, stillness regains. So what is the meaning of eerie? Strange, delicate, very soft, whistle chirruping, that is a chirruping, whistling sound, onomatopoeic word that gives the sense, the very sound gives the sense. Launches away means flies away. Infinite means endless. And subsides means comes down. माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम दिस वेरी पोएम अ क्वेश्चन रिकार्स दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. डिस्क्राइब द लेबनान ट्रीज टॉप इन द बिगनिंग. नेक्स्ट कम्स डिस्क्राइब द अराइवल ऑफ गोल्ड फिंच टू द लेबनान ट्री एंड डिस्क्राइब द सिंगिंग ऑफ द गोल्ड फिंच. सो एज फार एज द आंसर टू द वेरी क्वेश्चन डिस्क्राइब द लेबनान ट्रीज टॉप इन द बिगनिंग, आंसर इज द लेबनान ट्री टॉप इज एम्प्टी एंड साइलेंट एज इज गिवेन इन द वेरी फर्स्ट स्टैंजा. इट इज डेवॉयड ऑफ ऑल एक्टिविटीज एंड साउंड्स. इन द येलो सेप्टेम्बर सनलाइट सम ऑफ इट्स लीव्स आर टर्निंग येलो एंड ऑल इट्स सीड्स हैव फॉलन. The tree presents a picture of inactivity, dullness and emptiness. And what happens with the arrival of goldfinch? The goldfinch comes and perches itself at the top of laburnum tree. Its arrival is abrupt and sudden. It starts its sharp and jerky chirpings. It surprises and startles with its sharp sounds. It keeps on jumping from one end of the branch to the other. And as far as song of the describe the singing of the goldfinch, there are I would like to just remind you that there are various onomatopoeic words are used to describe, to just give a sense of that its singing. The goldfinch is a small, sweet singing bird. It is sleek and alert, agile, like a lizard, very smart. Understood. Abruptly, she enters the thickness and starts singing, chitterings, whisperings, and trillings are various sounds, onomatopoeic words that are produced while she sings. With the sweet sounds, the whole tree trembles and thrills in excitement. Another question also comes, how does the laburnum tree become the engine of her family? Very important question. I would like to discuss when we have got scope also. The goldfinch's sudden and abrupt arrival brings the tree to life again. The whole tree trembles and thrills with the chitterings and trillings of the goldfinch. She is the engine of her family. And an engine, as an engine, she makes different whistling and sounds. With her song, the laburnum tree becomes an engine of the goldfinch's family. One explanation is also required as far as bird face is concerned. How does the bird shows her BARRED bird face identity mask? The goldfinch flutters from one branch to the other. It has many stripes all over her face. This bird having stripes, bird means having stripes, this bird face has become her identity mask or sign of recognition. She lovingly stokes the tree and then flutters out to the other end of the branch. What happens to the laburnum tree when the bird flies away? After flirting from one end to the branch to the other, the goldfinch flies away into the infinite. It takes away all those sweet sounds, thrills, and exciting moments with her. The laburnum tree becomes empty and silent again. One question I would like to just discuss also. Describe the relationship of the laburnum tree and the goldfinch. The laburnum tree and the goldfinch seem to be made for each other. The sudden and abrupt arrival of the bird brings life to the tree. The whole tree trembles and thrills with its chitterings and trillings. The moment the bird flies away, the tree becomes empty and silent again. Let's infer word meaning. Laburnum, a short tree with hanging branches, yellow flowers. Silent, quiet, quiet, adjective. And next, quite, my dear students, there is omitted, unintentional mistake is there. Quite still, quite. And this quiet, quite, this is adverb. Quiet still means completely motionless. Yellowing, turning yellow. Goldfinch, a small singing bird, bird hoga, bird with yellow feathers on its wings. Next, twitching means pulling or contracting with a jerk. Next, chirrup, an onomatopoeic word capturing the sound made by the goldfinch. Next, suddenness, abrupt. Startlement, amazement. My dear students, again there is L1 intruded, intrudes, understood. So it should be amazement, A-M-A-Z-E-M-E-N-T. Next, slick, smooth, abrupt, sudden or unexpected. Next, thickness, among the leaves and branches, chitterings, chirrupings. Tremor, shiver or jerky movements. Trillings, short high-pitched sound. Trembles, S-I-C-K-E-S-X. Thrills, gets excited. Stokes, hits lightly. Flutters out, flutters out. Bird, having stripes. Next word is bird face, adjective, B-A-R-R-E-D, adjective. Face having stripes, S-T-R-I-P-E-S, stripes on it. S-T-R-I-P-E-S, my dear students. Stripes. Identity means recognition. Mask means covering. Thank you for you have listened to me with the greatest concentration. Thank you.